Very good morning. This is Professor B. Balamurugan from School of Computing Science and Engineering, Galgutias University. The university is based in Uttar Pradesh. So I am going to talk upon a topic and insights into research and publications. So before I could enter into the topic and talk to you, let me first hand thank Professor T.C. Subbulakshmi, Associate Professor and HOD, IT Department, and Dr. Tino Merlin, Assistant Professor, IT Department, Francis Xavier Engineering College, Tirunelveli. And I also thank Professor Veluchami, who is the current principal of the same college. So let's go into the topic. During this COVID period, you would have gone to several webinars based upon some concept or based upon some research. So almost you would have fed up hearing to webinars. But I will make sure this webinar on research and publication is better, and you will hear which you already don't know. Okay, if I say something that you already know, so make sure that you rewrite it, you top up it. Okay. So first, what is a publication? Everybody knows, like, publish or perish. So what do you mean by publish or perish? It means that if you are a faculty of computer science or IT or ECE, mechanical or civil engineering or any faculty, the one thing what you must do is publish. Okay. So if you don't publish, at end of every academic year, you will be asked, what is your publications, or what is the number of books you have edited? What is the number of books you have authored? How many number of premium conference you have gone? All that stuff. Okay, so that will be a problem for your career. So if you see in the academic field, those people who have properly published are always free and they'll have a very good time. Okay, so I have my phone number and email ID here. So if anybody wants to communicate with me, you can do that. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a screen. The first thing what I'm going to share with you is how to find good journals. Okay, so either you can go to scopus.com. Everybody knows it, www.scopus.com, where you can find all the journals which are Scopus Index. So the first thing you have to follow is the minimum benchmark what you have to keep is Scopus. Okay, so you can ask me a question. So I should not go to UGC journal. You have different types of UGC journal. Should I go or not? So if you keep Scopus as the minimum thing, it will be very good for you, because Scopus is always considered to be global, and there is not much of probability that Scopus will be taken away, or it will be said that we will not accept Scopus. But on the other hand, when you go for a UGC journal, there is a possibility that at times they will say that this journal has gone out of UGC. I will not look into that profile with that thing. Okay, got it. So that is a problem. So you can go to Scopus and you can go to sources and you can download all the journals that are Scopus indexed. But for that, you need to have Scopus. If you don't have Scopus access in your university or college, you will not be able to do that. So I can click all the journal and I can export into Excel. So I have almost 41,154 results. Okay. So if I don't have Scopus, what I should do? Okay, I can go to Google. I'm going to type a site called SCIMAGOR. MAGOJR. Okay, so this is the site I'm going. So I'm repeating it again. So I'm going into a site called SCIMAGOJR. I'm clicking it. Okay, so here I have got a web page. So here I can find out the journal rankings. The first mistake what people do is they will not be finding a good journal for their publication. So first thing what you have to do is you have to select a topic. So if you are a budding researcher, you can select a very good topic. Okay, so how to select a topic, I will say after this. Okay, so here I can go to this website and I can find out on what I'm going to do research. So I can select the subject area. So my subject area is computer science. So I can put computer science. Okay, in computer science, I have several categories, subject categories. I have artificial intelligence, computational theory, computer graphics, computer network, computer science application, computer science. So I can just choose any one of that. But since I don't choose any particular thing, I can just put all category, all subject category inside computer science. Okay. So here you can see all the journals listed out. So like you can see the top journal to the bottommost journal. Okay, so I can even filter only Web of Science journals. I'll be getting the filter. So if I don't want the filter, then I can remove it. So how journals are categorized? First, you should understand journals are categorized into four: Q1 journals, Q2 journals, Q3 journals, and Q4 journals. So if you take the SJR value, see this is Q1 journal they have listed. So if I'm plusing this, I will be getting the journals which very less SJR value, that is Q4 journals. Okay, so here these are the least journals. So how they are calculating this SJR values, H-index, citations, impact factor, you need not to know about it. It's not very important. But if a paper from a journal is cited several times by people, then it automatically, its citation grows. Once the citation grows, automatically the impact factor also grows. So that is the technique. So after this, so I have found out all the journals, so it will be easier for me to read it. Okay. So if I am working in artificial intelligence, then I can click on artificial intelligence. So the journals that are related to artificial intelligence alone will come. So artificial intelligence is a subject that has to be taken up by all the people. Even if you are working in image processing, you have to use artificial intelligence. If you are working in bioinformatics, still you have to use. Even if you are working in mechanical engineering, AI uses. So after few years of time, maybe after 5 years of time, nobody will say computer science. It will be turned into AI, artificial intelligence. Or even they may say a word, deep learning also. Because everything is being hijacked by artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. So you should follow the track. Okay. The second thing, now you know what are the journals, everything. Now you can easily select. There is another site which most of you know. Okay. So this is called as Guide to Research. Guide to Research. Okay. So this is a quite authentic site to know about journals. Okay. So if I'm going for all the conferences, I will come to conferences later. I don't want to confuse you people. So here I can go. After I go here, I can go for this top journals. Once I go here, I can have all the categories. If I want to know all the journals in hardware, robotics, and electronics, or image processing in computer vision. So these are the journals which are top journals. So if I want to know for all categories, so now they have categorized the journal according to the rank. Okay. So if you see, this is the topmost journal, IEEE Communication Service and Tutorials. Okay. I think it is somewhere around 20 plus impact factor. See, it is 20.230 impact factor. So they have calculated the impact factor and they have listed. So if you have really good aim, you can say that by 1 year, I will be publishing in this journal. So this is a top computer science journal. It is also the top electronics journal. It is also the top electrical journal. So in the circuit branch, this journal is top. Okay, so if you see, most of the IEEE journal has taken the top position. So there is a Springer in 11th position. Another Springer, Elsevier, World Scientific Net, Sage, all are there. But most of the journal from IEEE have taken a good position. And what you have to do, and whenever you go to abroad or whenever you go for an interview or whenever you go for a postdoc, they'll be asking how many number of IEEE journals you have, how many number of IEEE transactions you have. That is what they'll be asking. So make sure in your resume, you should be having at least 5 to 6 IEEE journals. It's based upon your experience. So you have just completed your PhD. It's good. You can make sure that you can have ultimate time to do research. You don't have any stress, so you can do it. So on the other hand, if you're doing research, do it happily. Once you do happily only, you will be able to do research. Okay. Coming to the point. Okay. Like I'm going to find out my topic. How to find out a topic? It doesn't mean that I go to Google, type some keywords and get a paper and say that this I'm going to submit an abstract to a university where I'm going to register PhD. Then automatically I will keep doing it. So that's not going to work. Okay. If the topic or the area of research you are choosing is very well defined, is well chosen, then you will not be having much of challenges doing your PhD. And there is another statement also. Whenever you have chosen your problem right and you know your problem exactly what you are going to do, it means that you already have completed 50% of the solution. In most of the cases, they would have already completed several DC doctoral committee meetings and they would have already gone to synopsis. You ask them what is your problem, that is a research problem, they will not be saying it. On one day, they will say one research problem. On the other day, they will be saying another research problem. So that happens because of poor literature survey. So whenever I want to have a proper problem and if I want to find out a proper research gap, I have to do extensive literature survey, then only it will work. Okay. So how to choose a topic is what I was saying. So there are a lot of sites that will do analytics and they will be like giving us some trends. Okay. So during 2020, what will be the trend? Anyway, during 2020, there will not be much of trend because COVID-19 is the trend and not much of research is happening. Maybe like because most of the labs are closed. Most of the universities are closed. So during 2019, they would have already decided what will be the trend of 2020. Okay. If I'm just putting a word, I'm putting in Google, computing trends 2020. Okay. So there will be sites. There are sites which will do analytics. Okay. So in that one site is Gartner, G-A-R-T-N-E-R. That's a very awesome site. So which is more authentic. We should, whenever we are taking a live decision of finding out on what area I'm going to work. So I have to believe authentic thing. Okay. So here they have given the top 10 strategic technologies of 2020. If you say they have given a statement called hyper automation, multi-experience, democratization of expertise, human argumentation, transparency and traceability, the empowered edge, distributed cloud, autonomous thing, practical blockchain, AI security. So nobody would have much heard about this. Though it is not a new term, it is a combination of already existing techniques. So hyper automation is a combination of machine learning and automation. So you already know about RPA, robotic process automation. Multi experiences, combination of VR, AR, and MR. Okay, means virtual reality, augmented reality, and mixed reality. So like that they are given. So in case, if I'm going to join research, so I have to consider any one of this topic like blockchain. Okay, so why I have to take a proper topic? So when I take a proper topic that is latest, so you just imagine somebody is going to start a research now. So if they take an old domain topic, which has already been there for 10 years and people are working in it, it doesn't mean that you should not take a topic like image processing or networking. It is a good old topic and still there are a lot of improvements has to be done. with the help of combination of other domain topic. But still, you have to find out what is the trend. For example, blockchain is the trend now. Most of the security paradigms are moving towards blockchain, like that it is going. Okay. On the other hand, big data is doing very well. Big data analytics, a lot of analytics are happening with the help of artificial intelligence. AI, machine learning, deep learning are taken by all people, diversify people. So anything you do on it will be a hit. So like that, I want you to design your topic. So when I go for that Gartner, I will find out what is the topic. So first I will be choosing my domain. Then after that, I'll be choosing the topic. After choosing the topic, what I have to do, I have to, what usually people will be doing, they'll be going to Google. So they will be putting a topic. So for example, blockchain, they will put plus IEEE plus PDF, they will put, and they will start reading the papers, whatever they get. So this is a random reading. This will not work out. Okay. So whenever you are downloading a paper, it should be authentic, because who has written it? So how I will be choosing an authentic paper? Okay. So for example, if I'm going for a blockchain topic, so how, what I have to do is, I have to find out what are the journals that are there in blockchain. For that, I already gave you an, I have given you a page where I can find the top journals. Okay, so what is the name of it? SCIMAGOJR. Okay, so here I'm going for journal ranking. Okay, so here I'm going to find the subject area, computer science. So in case I'm going to find out, I'm working on AI, I'll choose AI and I'll find out. So what I want journals, not book series, conferences or trade journals. I click upon journals. So I want, I'm selecting a country. It's let it be like, I don't want any other country. So let me choose only Europe, Latin America. Yeah, I'm choosing Latin America. Okay, not a problem. Okay, so here, so now I get all the journals that are related to artificial intelligence. You can see all the good journals will be here. So now what I have to do? So I can choose one journal, copy it, and I have to go here. So I have to enter into the journal. Then I have already chosen a topic inside artificial intelligence. So I have to choose. So now you see IEEE transaction on pattern analysis and machine intelligence, which is related to artificial intelligence. Okay. So see, machine learning, artificial intelligence, image understanding, pattern analysis, everything is here. And the impact factor is 17.730. So people who have written paper for it would have really written nice papers only. Otherwise, it is not possible to get this paper inside the 17 impact factor journal. So what I'm going to do, I'm putting all issues, or let me put current issue. That will be much, much better. So here, if you see, I'll find lot of papers. Okay. First, I have chosen a domain. Now I have to read lot of papers. Okay. So whenever you are choosing a problem, it should not come out of your common sense. It should come out of your knowledge. So how to gather knowledge is by reading lot of papers. Okay. So usually I even still doubt those who have finished PhD, how many number of papers they have read, whether they have read the paper extensively, in depth, completely. If they see equation, they should not jump. If they see a tabular column, they should really analyze. Okay. So if anybody does complete reading, then automatically they will get a proper problem. Okay. So you have to, how to download this papers, everybody knows. So you can say that, sir, it takes a lot of crores of rupees to subscribe to all IEEE, Springer, every journal. Okay. So what you can do, if you want to read this, okay, and if it is not open access or open source, everybody knows about this website, SCI Hub. So even bigger universities will be using that, because they will not be able to subscribe to all the journals. There is nothing wrong in using Sky Hub. Okay, so I went to a site called sci-hub.tw. So I can copy the link of the paper which I want. Okay. So I will be getting the paper. It'll take some time to come. Let me click it. Okay, let it come. We'll wait for it. Okay, so I can go for SCA Hub and I can download the paper. So whenever you are downloading the paper, make sure that paper is worth to be downloaded. So just don't go to SCA Hub and download some 40-30 papers and don't keep it in your system, not reading it. Okay, so see, it is automatically downloaded. So this paper is really good. How I am saying is the journal is very good. Plus, they have a lot of related works, proposed framework they have given. They have given the algorithms. They have given real data set name, how they have done. Experimental result is given. Proposed work is proper. They have given what are their objective, how they are fulfilling the objective. Graphs they have given. Everything they have given properly. Okay. So this makes sense. Okay, so this is how I'm going to download a paper. Okay, so I have chosen a domain, I have chosen a topic. First, after that, after choosing a topic, what I have to do is, I have to make sure I collect good papers out of the topic. For that, I will not go for random check, but I will go for selecting top journals, then going into the journal, downloading the papers. Okay, so by doing this, already you would have got to know what are the journals that are related to your topic. So if it is my topic, I will have always top 5 journals. Okay. So it means that whenever I can go to the journal page and I can say that whenever a new paper comes, give me a message. Okay. I can create a login inside IEEE and I can have I can add an alert in the journal by which whenever a new paper comes related to my topic, it will give you a message to me. It will ping me. So I can immediately go there and I can read it. Okay. So I should be updated. What do you mean by updated? So in my journals of interest, whatever new things comes, I should know it. At least I can read the abstract on the go. I can read what is happening, how people are evolving, how the techniques are evolving, how the process are evolving. I should be knowing it. Okay. So now I have chosen the papers. So now it's right time to write a survey paper. So what is a survey paper? I already told. Okay. Let's go to a journal called IEEE Communication Survey and Tutorial. I told no, it's 20 Impact number one journal. Let me go inside that. So this journal is particularly designed to do only surveys. Okay. It is particularly designed only to do surveys. Only surveys are accepted. 22 impact factor. Okay. So you can see the popular articles. So if you see the papers, it is like Internet of Things, a survey on enabling technologies, protocols, and applications. Survey on data mining, machine learning methods for cybersecurity intrusion detection. A tutorial on IEEE 802.11. It should be old, but it's a very good one. Next generation 5G wireless networks. Okay, got it. So if you go here, okay, if I want to download this paper, I'm going to Sky Hub again. And I'm just putting the link of the paper, which I have copied from here. And I'm just waiting for my paper to be uploaded. Okay. So whenever a person is going to do a research, the first thing he has to do, he or she has to do, is write a literature survey. It can be a comprehensive survey, it can be a comprehensive review, or it can be a position paper, it can be anything. So that is what I have to do. So see, the paper has come. So let's check what the survey is about. It is a paper that is published in 2016. So they have written abstract, they have written introduction, they have written about what is 5G, they have drawn a very good diagram, architecture diagram. So in 2016, that was the time when 5G was up. So So they have given a comparison chart. They have given architecture, how it works. So extensive comprehensive survey. You can imagine the way they have written. Whenever you are doing a review or survey, it must be having a lot of tabular columns, means comparisons. Okay. So they have, if you see the number of pages, you will be knowing how good it is. And if you can see like what number of references they have taken, 233 references. And all the references are, should be good ones, hand-picked. Each of the reference should be hand-picked. For just, as I told, for collecting the references, if you work very hard, you can use the references till your end of research, after research also. There are websites like Mendeley. Okay, so Mendeley, it's a desktop application which will be helping you to collect this reference papers and keep it in a place. So you can make use of this. There are many softwares like this. You can use any one of this. And if you want to do research fastly and good research, you have to make sure that you use good research tools. Okay. So this Mendeley tool is used for collecting references. So these are my references. Like that, you can, if you want to draw a diagram, there are a lot of tools are there, like Inkscape. There are many other tools are also there, which can be used for drawing freely. And whenever writing the paper, try to use LaTeX. So you know about LaTeX. Okay. When you go for LaTeX, it's a document preparation system. Okay. So this will give more quality to your research. Though it will take a lot of time for you to learn this or use it, there are like, there is a website called Overleaf where LaTeX is made easy. Just need to log in, you know, to install anything. You can create your template. You can create your template about your journal. You can make PPT. You can make your resume, everything. Templates are very neatly given. Academic journal, you click for what journal you want. They have given LaTeX format. Okay, so you can just choose the journal. So automatically you can, I can search for my journal also. Okay, so this is one thing is available. Okay, for doing a tabular column, there are a lot of tools are there. For drawing graphs, it's very, very important. Most of you will be using Excel. Make sure you don't use Excel unless it is not needed. There are some research that is really good research can be done on data analytics using Excel also. Advanced Excel features are very good, which can really generate good graphs. But still, when you are using, when you are drawing graphs for some other purpose, make use of some other tool. For example, let me say about a tool like GNU Plot. Okay. So this is a very good tool, GNU Plot. So where you have a lot of graphs, demos of the graph, tutorials and guides. See, I can show you demo, many demos of the graph, any kind of graphs you can draw. Okay, because source code is available and this can be integrated with your LaTeX also. So like this is there, you can download this and any kind of graphs you can do. When you are drawing this, this number of graphs are there from simple function graph code is there. So whatever I want, I can change here to do change here. So that is easy. You can give a try. Okay. So one more point I like to add is you need to have good research tools to improve your research and bring out quality research. That's very, very important. Okay. So now you have chosen the domain, you have chosen topic, you have chosen the journals. Now you have downloaded good papers from the journals and you know how to download the papers. So now you have to assemble the paper and you have to write the organization for your research survey or review paper. I have to write an organization. So what will be the organization? I have to have a discussion with my guide or with my friends. So I'll be having this kind of title. I'll be having abstract. I'll be having introduction. I'll be having after that related works. I'll be having my proposed work or my objectives. After that, I'll be having my methodologies. Even survey have a methodology. What method you followed to download papers? What method you followed to review the paper? Everything. Okay. Then what are the objectives you have written? What is the conclusion? What are the outcomes of the paper? How? What is your contribution? It doesn't mean that I will take 200 papers. Write one paragraph for each of the 200 papers and say I have done a comprehensive survey. No, it will not work out. Review. What do you mean by review? If you have seen a movie review, what they will say? They will not say the story of the movie, but they will talk about the color in the movie, the acting skills of the actors in the movie. They will talk about the lightings, the small things in the movie. Same like that. When I'm reviewing a paper, I should find out the flaws in the paper, but I should not be very critic, but I can just judge to some extent. I can say how the paper is written. What is the gap in the paper? I can say that this paper has certain limitations. These limitations I can arrange. If I have 100 papers, in the 100 papers, what kind of limitations are there? I have to make sure I know about it. Once I make sure about the limitations, I'll be getting hundreds of limitations. Once I get hundreds of limitations, what will happen is I'll be easily knowing like what is the main, what is the major research gap that is already available and how I'm going to overcome that. The research gap that I have found using my survey will become my research idea or the objective of my complete research. Once I get the research gap, from there I will be devising my research statement, which is problem statement. It can be as simple as this: finding out security flaw in IoT platform and coming out with a novel efficient algorithm for doing or overcoming the security by means of fuzzy logic. It can be like this. So simply, I should not say novel. When I say novel, it should be really novel. I have reviewed many of the papers. So when we used to review, we used to see like people will be writing like novel, efficient, effective, modern, all that stuff. But when you are saying novel, the reviewer will first see what is the novelty in the paper, whether they have recreated something or they innovated something or they have given a really good outcome. So make sure your title is not very fancy. It should be the abridge of your whole paper. Means what is the whole paper? It has to be properly defined by the title. The whole paper should be scaled down to abstract. The abstract should be scaled down to title. Okay. So now coming to the title. Okay. So how to keep a title? That again is a big challenge. Okay. So many titles are there. If I paste a title that is already available in Google, so I have to make sure that the title is kept initially. That is a working title. Doesn't mean that it need to be there till the end of the paper, because if you're really focused, then you will be like writing the paper exactly to the title, but you are supposed to write to the title, because you write a title, then you will be writing the overall skeleton of the paper. So what you can even write, I'm going to use this 10 papers. I'm going to use this tool. I'm going to use this mathematical models. I'm going to make use of this algorithm. Okay, talking about algorithm, every paper, preferably, it should be having one or more algorithms in it, because that is the heart of the paper. So whenever you are having an algorithm, you have to make sure that it is written very properly. It is written in an understandable manner and it is written very properly. So whenever a reviewer goes to a paper for analyzing how good or bad it is, so he or she will review the title. After that, they will go to the abstract. After that, they will be going to the algorithm or proposed model. They will not be reading the introduction. They will read the abstract again and introduction again after finding out whether your graphs are novel or good or believable. What is your results? What kind of contribution you have given? So whenever I'm saying about contribution in a whole paper, you should have at least 40 to 50% of contribution. It means that even I'm writing a survey or review paper, I should not write take one paragraph from each of the paper, and I should not start writing my survey paper, but I should be a critic. I already same like that when I'm writing an implementation paper. So I should write a content that is not available in other content. Okay. So while writing a paper and taking references, you can also choose contents from patents. Patents is also a knowledge base platform which you can use. Okay. So you can go to Google Patents, which is available. This is patents.patent.google.com. So I can go for Google Patents. Okay, so I can go for patents.google.com and I can search it. Okay, patents.google.com. Again, here I can do, if I'm putting a smartwatch, just I'm putting. All the content related to smartwatch will be there. I can download it. PDF, I can download. I can understand it. Okay, so this has been done in Japan. Okay, so I can go for US patent also. Okay, so here. So when I'm saying smartwatch, it has come long back only. Before 20 years, they have patented it. Okay, so I can use this also. I can use books, contents of the book. How to use the contents of the book? So I'm going to books.google.com. Okay, so I'm going for books.google.com. Here I can, if I want a book from which mathematical model plus blockchain, I want to do something on it. It's very new. Okay, so see, already it has come. Mathematical research for blockchain economy. So here also I can understand a book. So how the book is like. Nobody visits books, nobody visits patents, nobody go for any other resources. But these all resources also should be considered for writing papers. Okay, so whenever you want to do your research, first thing what you have to do is you have to consider reading the Indian author test books that are available in the domain, because that will be easy to read. And you have to read on one sitting. Okay, how you read an English novel or a Tamil novel or a Hindi novel, same like that. You have to make sure that you read this test books on a go. Don't worry whether you understand it or not completely. You will understand to some extent according to the previous knowledge you have. But start reading it, like data structure, system software, compiler design, theory of computing, DBMS. All these are the core subjects of computer science. Anybody want to do a research on artificial intelligence and other things, or big data, should also have basic fundamental knowledge of what is the foundations of computer science. So if you take computer science, the foundations will be mathematics. So if you see any of the good papers, it will be having a lot of mathematical thing in it. If I'm looking into a security paper, I'll have a lot of number theory contents. If I'm looking into an artificial intelligence based concept, I'll be having a lot of transformation, graph theory. So if I go for some other kind of research, I'll be having Laplace transformations. I'll be having other mathematical contents. So if I'm going for deep learning, artificial intelligence, I will be 100% in need of probability, because I do a lot of predictions, analysis, all that stuff. Okay. So without knowing mathematics, so if you are working in AI, ML, deep learning, mathematics in terms of statistics is foundation of that. Without knowing that, I will not be able to do it. So if I want to know about stat, if I'm putting statistics, plus what I can do, like machine learning, I will get a lot of books. And I can download the books by some means. When I read this kind of thing, then I go to programming. If I go for R programming or Python programming, this statistical knowledge will be useful for me. Okay, so that is how a proper research has to be carried out. Okay, so next topic. So now you know like how a good paper has to be written. So you can ask me a question, sir. How to target top journals? So let me go to my profile, Balamurugan Balusami. Okay. So I'm just putting my profile. I'm going to Google Scholar. I'm clicking the year. Okay, so you can see the publication of 2020. I have somewhere on this month's publication. Let me see. Everybody will have a lot of publication in Google Scholar. Okay, so the main thing but you have to consider is Scopus.com, where the reality will be there. Okay, so here if you see this is a book, this is a journal of parallel and distributed computing. This is from Elsevier. I have got my paper over here. It's a very good journal. So then if you see, I have another paper from Archives in Computational Methods and Engineering. This is also a very good paper. And the journal is of, let me show you the journal, 7 Impact Factor. So it's a good one, not a bad one. Okay, so here you can go to Scopus and put Balusami Balamurugan. You can see the affiliation. Every one of you must be having a Scopus ID. That is what will be counted. If you don't have a Scopus ID, make it. And there is a possibility that all your papers will be scattered here and there. See, I had 4 or 5 IDs. I merged it to one. See, but still I have 2 IDs. In one ID, I have 96 documents. Another ID, I have 5. Still, if I merge, I'll become 101. So I can just click on this to find out the real Scopus. This also will have ACI papers also inside it. So this is where it counts. So if you're going for a bigger place, for an interview or for showing your profile, they will see your Scopus profile only. So these are the papers. Okay. So like that. Okay. So this is, I told you, I published on the 2.5 impact factor. Why I'm showing is not to flaunt that I have done this, but to show how to write papers for it. Okay. So let me go here. Okay. So I told in this journal, I have communicated and got acceptance. So this is the paper, original paper. Okay, till then let's go here. So another paper is on transaction, this is a Wiley transaction. Another one is a book, another one is this, another is a book. This is IEEE transaction journal. This is IEEE access. So initially, when I started my research, I was not having so many of papers, but how to get your top journal papers is you have to have collaboration also. So there is a myth that Asian people will not write a good paper. Their English will not be great. That is not only a myth, but probably true also, because here the way they are writing the paper is not very appreciable. Okay. So they don't write very good papers. So in order to break the myths, what you have to do is you have to start collaborating with people outside the country. Okay. So how to collaborate with people? Simply, I should mail them. Okay, you can mail them. You will be getting a reply. But after that, what you'll do? They will be starting to give work to you, whether you will be capable and able to do the work on time. So for example, if you are collaborating with a Chinese guy, so the Chinese are very fast workers. They don't even get married. They will be simply keep doing the research. So if you take the number of top country in publications, China is number one, second is US. Because each of the faculty are given so much of funds to even publish in open access journals. Okay, so if you take MDBA journals, IEEE access journals, they all Chinese people come and publish over there. Because if I'm coming out with a new concept, so if I want to popularize the concept, then I have to go for open access. So anybody, even without any subscription, can download that and they will popularize the content. Okay. So now we'll go for how to publish in this good journals. For that, I told we need to go for collaboration. So how to go for collaboration is, so you have to attend good conferences. Okay, there are a lot of conferences happening in India, but you have to make sure you at least go out of the company, country, if not to European countries and Americas, at least you try to go to Asian countries like Singapore, Malaysia, where ample number of good conferences are happening. Or otherwise, there are also top conferences that are happening in India. It takes turns to happen in India. Plus, there are also conferences that are happening in IITs and NITs, which are very much respected. So if we can present your paper in an IIT, okay. So if we can present your paper in IIT in front of a jury which has been derived from IITs, IIITs, and NIT, then okay, you are very good, okay, at least more than average. So it can be considered that. Okay, so I already told you how to find good conferences. Okay, there is a research to guide to research I told you, for example. So otherwise, I'm just putting top computer science conferences. So there are top computer science conferences there, which are world renowned. Okay. For example, Infocom, Globecom, SICCOM, SC. All these conferences are supercomputing, top conferences. So people who are working in this kind of thing, if people who are working in computer vision and pattern recognition will make sure they publish this paper here. And why they publish is not only for the paper, but to meet other people who are working on the same domain. So if somebody is working on machine learning, they will make sure they go for these conferences. Okay, so you can see the H-index. It is very good H-index, 135. And the call for is there. And getting selected in this conference is not very easy. Plus you have to visit, you have to give a talk over there. You have to make sure that people understand your concept and the contribution you are going to give are very good. So you should know all this stuff. Okay. So you can also choose a good conference, though it is expensive. I know conferences are expensive because of the registration fee. So if you have friends in US, they will be able to pay for you and make sure that each of them in the paper are contributing something. There should not be any passive author inside your paper. So once you start adding passive authors, the quality of the research what you're going to do will not be sounding good. People will not like you eventually. Okay. So how to get a good citation? Okay, so you can write a paper, but after that they will be seeing what is your H-index. They'll be asking what is your H-index. So what I have to do, I have to make sure that I publish a paper which is cited by many people. How to do that? So I have to write a lot of review papers. When I write a lot of review papers, then automatically my citing will be high. Means many people will read review papers, so they will cite my paper. So once my citation increases, automatically my H-index will increase. Otherwise, what I can do, I have to make sure that I write a content that is very much needed. Okay, so there are some concepts in which the number of papers are very less. So people keep on citing the same papers that are already available. Because of the same thing, the citations will increase for the people who are writing in that kind of area. Second thing is, how to find out what is the trend? Even if you haven't completed your PhD, you can become a reviewer in any of the journals. You can go to any journal. For example, I'm going for Springer Journal. Plus reviewer application, if I'm going. So see, anybody can become a reviewer. And there is another site called Publons, P-U-B-L-O-N-S, Publons. You can go to Publons and register and you can become a reviewer. You will get reviews. Okay. So like, why to review? Once you review, you will be knowing what kind of papers are written by people who are working in a particular domain. Okay, so this Publons will help you to become a reviewer also. So once you read a lot of papers which are not yet published, you will get a good knowledge about it. Okay. So next thing what I'm going to talk about. So I have spoken about research collaboration also. Okay. So then there are other things are also there. Editing books. So like if I want to edit a book as a researcher, I have completed my PhD. I have to start editing books. So how to edit a book? Okay. I will give that as a separate topic to you on later time to come. Okay. So for example, if I'm just putting Springer book series, I will get a lot of book series. So what I have to do is I can go to any of the book series. So here it is. I will go to my subject, computer science. Okay, got it. So in this, I go for AI. So these are the future journals in Springer. These are the proceedings, conference proceedings. These are the future books that are published. These are the future test books that are published. These are the future book series. I can choose one book series. Okay. And what I can do, see, books published in this series, anybody can publish. Okay. So who are the editors of the series? This guy is the editor of the series. Okay. So they have given a serial flyer, series flyer. Can you see this? Hopefully, I think you are seeing this flyer. Okay, so they have given whom to contact. If you go for the flyer, they're given whom to contact. So I can write a plug. Sorry about this. Okay, got it. No share again. I'm going to back to my Safari. Okay, so I can send an email to them that I'm interested to edit a book for their series and they will reply to you. Okay, and after that, they will send something called a book proposal form where you can write about the topics on which you are going to edit the book. Like there are many book series are there, like genetic and evolutionary computing. So here you can contact with this persons. Like that, you can start editing and authoring books. Okay, the book editing is also very important. Like you have Springer, Elsevier is also having books, CRC Press is having books, that is Taylor and Francis, IEEE is having books. So you can just put list IEEE books. These are very, very authentic book and it is of very good respect. So I can go to book publication in IEEE. Here again, they have given the proposal forms. Anybody can submit this and prospective authors. If you're an author, you can send this. Or if you want to send a book proposal, short ebook proposal. They are also having ebooks. They are also having normal books also. You can go here like that. ACM books is there. So anybody who are a doctorate or non-doctorate can edit books. So you know about edit book. Editing book is something like I will write a title, I will write some chapters and each of the chapters will be written by some person. In authored book, there will be 3 or 4 people who will be writing the entire book. So that is the difference between edited book and authored book. Okay. The next thing what I'm going to talk upon is special issues. Okay, good. Okay, got it. So like if you want to go for a fast publications, I'm not talking about PhD publications, but past publications, you have to go for call for papers. So there is something called special issues, call for papers in what area I want, artificial intelligence. Okay, so all the special issue call that are there in artificial intelligence will be visible. So I have gone to a journal, which name of the journal only is artificial intelligence, it's from Elsevier. So there are so many of special issue calls are there. What do you mean by special issue call? Your journal will be calling for a special call by which I can write a paper only confined to this particular topics. So this human-centric explainable, theoretical philosophical, explainable black box model, knowledge representation like that. Okay, so why I have to do so means they have a time period. So it means that within the time period and the end of certain time, others time period, my publication will be already available. So that makes sense. But when I go for regular issue, it will be taking more time than a special issue. And if you are a doctorate, you can get your own special issues and make sure that you get many papers from diversify people around the country and you can be an editor. So for example, this special issue has an editor. So these are the people. So like that, you can also take special issue and become an editor. So this is about special issue. Okay. Next thing what I'm going to talk upon is how to write mathematical model. So I have gone to the journal so that you will not be having a tough content. Now I'm going for another tough content. How to write mathematical models. Okay. So what basically is a mathematical model? So like you have seen many papers with a lot of mathematical theories, foundations, verifications, and lemmas. There is something called lemmas. And so like that. So why they are writing? So whenever I am writing a system model or mathematical model, it means that I'm trying to reduce the number of words. So if I'm going for a conference paper where I have a restriction of using only 6 to 8 pages, what I'll be doing is certain things which I have to define, I can define by means of constructing a mathematical model. For example, if I want to define the whole of galaxy, I can't write it in sentence. It will take at least some 300 pages, but still I can write a mathematical model. I can just consider this space as X, and within the X, what are the components or the sun, star, moon, all that stuff. And what is the relationship between how sun and star are related, how they are connected, what is the equation, everything I can write. And after that, I can just form an entire like black hole into an equation. That is a possibility. Same like that. If I have a system, it will be having input, output, it will be having process, it will be having components that are external to it, which doesn't play a lot of role. On the other hand, there will be some component that plays a very vital role. Like that, there will be so many of things that are there in a system. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be collecting all this together and I'll be writing a mathematical model. So certain things like what defines the limitation of the system, what defines the limitations of the research can also be considered for this. Okay, hopefully you like this lecture. Okay, so I talked about publications, high impact publications, and high impact publication when you are doing, there should not be any mistakes. Okay, it means that if I say why a paper is being rejected, the first reason is mistake. So as an Indian author, you will not be knowing about present tense, past tense, idioms and phrases. You will not be knowing about direct speech, indirect speech. So there are ways of doing that. Okay, so let's see like that. For example, English for researchers. If I'm putting this, I can get a very good book. Okay. So there is a book that is published by Springer. And it is freely downloadable also. English for writing research papers. It's a very good book. So I can just go and put download, it will come. So you can download it. Here they have given all the nuances of writing and how English should be written. Otherwise you can get it from Amazon also. So it is 384 pages, you can see that. So here, if I show you the index, okay, so what they have done, how to plan, what is the preparation you should do, how to structure your sentence, what should be the order of the word. So much they have gone in depth. So how to structure a paragraph. When you are writing a paragraph, it has a meaning. So I'm talking about something. I'm talking about movies in a paragraph. Suddenly, if I'm talking about something else, I'm talking about a snack, then there is a deviation between this talk and this talk. So it means that I have to put this in a paragraph, this again in a paragraph. Same like that. When I'm talking about a concept, I should talk about a concept. If little deviated, I have to go for a new paragraph. Doesn't mean that I will write 15 lines, then I will go for it. A paragraph can be of two lines also. It's all based upon the context on which I'm writing. So that is what they have well explained. What should be the first paragraph? What should be the middle paragraph? What should be the last paragraph? How we have to go for phrases? How, why I have to give, break up long paragraphs? When I have to start a new paragraph? How many people will write in a very stylish English? That's good. But still, you have to write in all the papers in a simple English so that people from all diversified places will understand. For example, take people of China. The people of China who are adult, in adult stage, they doesn't know English. People of China who are in the youth and child state, they are only learning English. So it means that if you're writing in a very great English, people from China will not be able to read it. Whole of the France and most of the Europe who are speaking French and German, they will not be able to read it. People from America, Latin America, who speak Spanish, Italian, they can't also read it. Okay, so only very less percentage of the people will be understanding. Okay, so you have to make sure that you write in a simple English that makes things more understandable. People will, what people will do, I have seen like researchers, they will go to Word and right click on a word and select the synonym and replace it. Each of the word has different meanings. So, and many people will write in a long sentences. Artificial intelligence can be used for studying human brain with the help of EEG signals and understanding and analyzing it by means of an algorithm based upon something like that. So it sounds good, but still the clarity of the sentence will not be there. So, and you should not use repeated keywords. The whole of the paper or whole of the lecture, somebody will say, okay, yes, something like that. So you should be concise and redundancy should be removed. So like this, they have given really, really good content. So highlighting your findings, discussing your limitations. So one of the major reasons of a paper to get rejected is not good English. So there are a lot of services available with IEEE authoring services. If I'm putting this, okay, I can go to IEEE author center. So if I'm really bad in English, okay, I have studied in a Tamil medium or Hindi medium, not a problem at all. Knowledge is different, English is different. So anybody can go here. I can go to author center and I can find out what I can do, like IEEE authoring center. Okay. Let me go here. See here, they have experts who can, American journal experts who can redefine, if you submit your paper, who can redefine, they will charge a bit. Who can redefine your English and if they can give in a good English. And one more thing. Another rejection of the paper is, so there is not much of contribution. Okay, so you have rewritten what is already available in books, blogs and sites. Then they will not accept it. Genuinity of the research. Simply adding some graph and saying that my research is better than somebody XYZ. That also will not work. It will work till UGC journal. It will work till Scopus journal. Even Scopus, many good Scopus Index journals are rejected. But after that, when you want to go for SCA or when you want to go for Web of Science or ISI, SCIE or SCI, almost all is going to become same, then you should really work to some extent. Okay. So this is the thing. Then after that, another mistake by which a paper will be rejected is organization of the paper. So you have to make sure the paper is organized very well. So the skeleton of the paper should be very well. The organization, the structure of the paper should be very well. It should be an understandable position. Everything should be clearly written, clearly visible, all that stuff. Okay. So another purpose of writing the paper is to make a thesis. So whenever you are writing the thesis, make sure all the paper you are writing should come into the thesis. So what do you mean by coming into the thesis? It means there should be, whenever you're writing a paper, it should be on a particular point of interest. Okay. So what do you mean particular point of interest is, I have to work on a particular domain. If I am analyzing EEG signal, then I have to make sure I do a lot of analysis. I have to find out a lot of classifier or classification algorithm, association algorithm related to that EEG signal, and I have to do it. Okay. This is one way. So like after that, what I can speak upon, I think I covered almost this funded project. Okay. So if you are a good researcher, what you must be having? You must be having conferences. Your resume must be having good conferences. You should attend at least 2 to 3 good international conferences, meet people there, network there. Then after that, you should be having Scopus papers. After that, you must be having SCA papers. After that, you should be having good chapters. After that, Scopus and DEC chapters. After that, you must have edited books. You must have authored books. After that, you would have got consultancy project. After that, you should have got funded projects. You know, a lot of funded projects are available. And people have a mind that only people, faculty from IIT and NIT will be getting the funded projects. It's not completely true. Any person from any small institute who is having a good capability and good problem defining skill and good problem solving skills can get it. So you can go to any time to DST site. So, or you can go for online DST, where there are a list of funded projects that are available. Okay, so I have to change the browser, otherwise DST funded projects I can go. Okay, so there are a lot of schemes are there. Okay, you can find out what are the schemes, which are the schemes that are open. I even applied for this scheme from Satyam special during the COVID period. There are a lot of special calls for which you will be getting results very easily. Okay, very fastly you will be getting the results. Okay, so how to write a funded project, I have to take for 1 or 2 hours. It is separate, but still you can see the call for example, you take this special call for Satyam. You see the advertisement. All right. So how, what is that they want? What kind of algorithms they want to be developed? What kind of this they have to develop? So whenever you're doing a funded project, directly I can't do a funded project, but what I have to do, I have to make use of students to do good final year projects. So you have to sit with them and help them to get final year projects. Means I have to choose a really good topic. In case they need some hardware, I will be able to procure it to some extent. Maybe if it is 5,000, 6,000, I will be able to get it for them. And I can find out from research. There are a lot of research labs available. For example, if I put AI research labs, that's US. I can find a lot of research labs available in US, where the good thing about is they will be giving the tools that they are using freely, and anybody can download and use the web tools. Okay, so there are a lot of center of excellences available. So you can go there. If you have any doubt, you can connect with them. So I just went to Penn State University. Research, what are the research they are doing? So what are the projects they are doing? This is very important. So you have to make sure that you are doing one such project with your final year students. So then you will have a setup where some real research happens. Then you will think, if I am given 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs or 5 lakh rupees, I can do extend this research in a beautiful way. So that time you have to go to DST and apply the project. So you need to have some preliminary results to get this. So for that, what you have to do, when you don't have anything at hand, but still you want to do good research, I can go to one such research labs and I can go and find what are the softwares they're using. Here they will not be using proprietary software, but they'll be giving the open source software that they have created. For example, they are giving some prediction software. Sorry for this. I think there is a problem with internet or a problem with the website. So who are the key people involved in it? So if you see the key people involved in it, you can mail them So they have a proper ecosystem. They have, so there will be one director or chair or faculty. He will be having postdoc under him. He will be having doctoral student under him. He'll have MSBS student under him. So you have this hierarchies. So same hierarchy we can form in our university also. The main thing about research is, you can ask me, I have published somewhere around 150 good papers and journals, 100 chapters, all that stuff. Because I have a very good working team. Okay, means nobody can do it alone. So you should form a proper research team. So for when you want to form a proper research team, you have to discuss research. Most of the problem arises when you don't discuss the research and think that you have $1 million research, and when you say that to somebody else, they will steal and they'll make $1,000 million. No, it's not going to happen. Whenever we discuss only, you'll get friends, and you should be having a proper team. When you have a proper team, then only you will be able to do good research. So with this, I'm concluding it. So otherwise it will be getting too bored for you. So I am sharing my contact ID again to you. So if you have any doubt, you can call me up. And again, I am thanking Subbulakshmi ma'am for giving me this opportunity. So this is not my calling number. This is only my WhatsApp. Thank you very much. Good luck.